Hey guys, what's going on today? Bojo here, and we are back with our NHL 15 Be a Pro series following Rick DiPietro and the Calgary Flames. So we are currently in the midst of this long Calgary Flames road trip here. We have not had a start a while since we played that LA Kings game, which unfortunately LA Kings showed why they were one of the best teams in the NHL, dealing us a 4-1 loss, and have not had a start since that game. And Calgary has just been riddled with injuries. We've lost our best defenseman in Mark Giordano, and our fourth line has just kind of been hammered. Defensively, we're not looking so good, so we have to see if we can get this team on the right track again. We have been losing a lot of games, so we're in Colorado tonight taking on the Avalanche, and hopefully we can get a win against them. So the stats, updates on the Avalanche. They are, I believe I checked, they were 12th for goals for. They had the same. They had a very similar goals against and goals for per game. I think they had a 2.8 goals for and a 2.8 goals against. So they can score a lot of goals, but they give up a lot of goals. And their penalty kill and power play were both top 5 in the league. So we want to make sure that we stay disciplined against this team. And if we do get a power play against them, though, we got to make sure that we capitalize on it or make the most out of it, because the odds of us getting something good happening on that power play or penalty kill, not looking too good. But look at those beautiful Rocky Mountains here in Denver, Colorado. Gonna be taking on the Avalanche here in the Pepsi Center with that huge ass jumbotron. I don't know how you guys in Colorado deal with that thing. That thing is enormous. Yep, Eddie Olczyk and Mike Emmerich doing the commentary tonight. So I would assume Varlamov's in that, unless something crazy happens, unless he's like injured or something like that. I don't know, but we'll see. They could start. We do have a negative record now, so I could see a team maybe starting another, like a different goaltender in net because of it. So who knows? There you go. There's an example. Calvin Picard, I guess, gets his NHL debut. I don't know if it's his NHL debut, but it might be his season debut here tonight. No records on the board, so Calvin Picard gets his first start of the year. And Rick DiPietro, 4-5 with a 1.83 goals against average, save percentage of .89, and 2 shutouts. Our save percentage pretty much stayed the same, but our goals against average went up. So we might have a chance in this game. Colorado does seem to be a team that lets up a lot of goals, and they're starting Calvin Picard for his first start of the year, I guess. And this could be a good chance for us to get a couple goals passed already. Up Graham with a shot, and though Picard will hold on, even though he was getting like a little nice little hug there from Hudler. I wonder if Varlamov's injured. I wonder if he's injured or not. I think maybe, you know what? Let me check that out right now, because I'm kind of interested in that. I just want to check the bench. If that's Varlamov right there, let's see. Is it Varlamov? Can I get rid of, how do I get rid of this thing? Hide. Is that Berra? Yeah, it's Rito Berra. Okay, so Varlamov is probably injured right now. So I guess Rito Berra gets a little break here as Calvin Picard gets his first shot start. So maybe that's why Colorado's not doing so good in their last 10. They lost their starting goaltender, Varlamov. He probably got hurt. So that's probably one of the reasons here. All right, so we might have run into a good team at a bad time here. Nice little blocker save, though, on that shot from Hudler by Picard. And Alex Tanguay taken off, though, and McKinnon will go offsides. All right, so Calgary, you guys got your shot here. You got a rookie goaltender in that. Don't be like the Flyers and make like these rookie goaltenders and these backup goaltenders look like goddamn superstars. All right, so they dump it in. Misplayed by the defenseman. Shot right in front by Marcus Granlund, but a glove save there from Picard. He's keeping the Abs in this game early. A couple shots already on that. That definitely could have been goals, but Picard staying strong there. He's a pretty good goalie, I know, in this game. All right, keep that in. Nope, Stajan's going to have to take it out. Gives it over to Russell. Back over to Weidman. Shot, like, hitting the back. Oh, somebody got injured. Oh, great. There goes down Chris Russell. Yeah, just when we didn't have enough defensive injuries. We have to deal with another one. God damn it. Bortolo takes out Chris Russell. And now we're going to have to deal with a shortened defenseman, I guess, now for the rest of this game. God damn it, dude. Another injured defenseman. I don't think Calgary has any more. I don't think we have any more guys in the minors to call up. We're going to have to call up somebody. Either that or play another fourth liner on defense and call up Klimchuk back up to the team. Oh, they're calling a penalty on that. Are they calling a penalty on that hit? Stajan's going to box or something. Ah, great. Here comes the top five, one of the top five teams in the league for power play. David Jones slashing. Yep. Calling for slashing or high sticking. Yep. Slashing on David Jones. All right, so here comes Stay Strong, Rick DiPietro. Stay strong, Rick. This is a top five power play in the league right now. All right, Raymond does good with the faceoff, and he will dump it down. And we'll set up. Eric Johnson now takes it, sends it back to Landeskog. Over to Matt Duchene. Look out for this guy. Matty Douche. Toe drags. Oh, Jesus. Pass in front. Diving Rick DiPietro. Tried to send it off to the back door, I think, to O'Reilly. And they don't get it out, though. Barry. Oh, Jesus, man. Gets the leg out. Oh, there's that pass from the point out in front to McKinnon, but we do make that save. Wide man up over the back of the net. Hold that post. Do not move. There you go. My goodness. Made that blocker save, and then McKinnon sent it right across the blue paint. And still managed to stay out. Who knows? McKinnon over to Landeskog. Tried to get it back to the point to Barry, but he was not there yet. Eric Johnson taken off, though, but he still gets it back up to Landeskog. Hook checked off by Weidman. Taken to the boards, though. Tries to set it back, though. Gets it back to himself. Landeskog turns back. There's that cross crease again. Up, oh, take that fight. Take that fight. Take that fight. Thank you. Well, there's going to be a roughing call. Someone's stepping up. Landeskog's stepping up for Matty Duchene. Landeskog and Sean Monahan throwing down already. Interesting. I want somebody to step up. The ref over here is freaking out. He's doing a little jig. I'm going to move out of the way for him so he can figure out what the hell he's doing. Hey, Picard! These guys' first NHL start. You want to go, bud? Rick DiPietro has not had a fight so far this year. Strangely enough. Hey, Picard, you want to go? All right, nope. Well, Captain Landy does win the fight over Sean Monahan, but fairly enough, I think Duchene ran me over. Somebody had to step up. But the Flames do kill off the penalty, which is surprising. They do kill off the penalty there from David Jones' slashing call. And it's still a 0-0 game. Rick DiPietro does keep the Abs off the board after a lot of trouble that they were giving me in the zone. And here we go. All right, Bortolo, can I dump that off? Oh, I do have it. There you go, Brody. They tried to poke check it off me, but they didn't. All right, Raymond. Oh, he's around. Raymond, low shot. He probably had enough room there to make a deke. If he goes backhand, that might have happened. Up, shot there from Marcus Granlund, but another glove saved, though, by Cooper Card, and he'll hold. Raymond had a lot of room on that right side of the post for a backhand shot. If he goes for a backhand, wow. Flames have not lost a faceoff so far. And they still haven't. Michael Backlund wins it. Oh, glove save, but he didn't get all of that. Barchi up right off of Picard. Sounding out in front, though. O'Reilly up. Poke checks, and they do get it back, though. Ryan O'Reilly up the wing. Stops up. Stops back up. Hits Duchene. Hits O'Reilly again. Wide the net, though. Nice shot. Slap shot McGinn. Back to O'Reilly. There's that cross crease again by Rick DiPietro over to make the save on that cross crease attempt. Goudreau, please get away from me. Thank you. Joel Colburn not playing forward. He's playing defense. I don't know why the hell he's all the way up the wing. That's his forward mentality, I guess. Gets it back to Backlund, surprisingly. Backlund out to Goudreau. Ooh, that might have went off the post. Backlund out in front to Barchi. Blocked in front by a defenseman. Rebound by Barchi. Spread eagle by Calvin Picard to fend off the low, slow-moving shot, and he keeps it out. All right, here's Tyson Barry. He'll dump it around. Gets over to O'Reilly. O'Reilly tried to dish it out, though, but Colburn's there, and he'll get it up to Granlund. Right, Marcus Granlund with Raymond on his wing as well. Granlund will dump it around. Gets tripped up a little bit. Duchene takes it now. Duchene up to Barry. Barry's playing forward, apparently. Oh, not anymore. You're not. Oh, okay, he hits him off the puck, but Barry gets it back. Barry out in front to... who was that who just took that shot? Number 21. Don't know who that is. Oh, my God. My notifications are still on. Mason Raymond. Mason Raymond around. Shot in front. Up. Oh, Hudler rebound. Up. Oh, Picard saves again. I don't know if that Picard saved that. Up. Oh, shot by Englund, I think, who stepped up into the play. But another save by Picard. Barry. 10 seconds left here. Jesse Winchester up to Street. Street taken to the boards right in front of the Colorado bench. And he'll just hold it there. Arnold will take it off. And that'll do it for the first period. So, a lot of craziness on both ends of the ice. Picard making some crazy saves. DiPietro making some crazy saves as well. And it is still a nothing-to-nothing game after the first period here. I kind of ran into Duchene myself. He didn't run into me. I ran into him. But Picard has made some saves. Puck's hitting the posts. And crazy first period here in Denver, as it is still a 0-0 game. Calvin Pekarek showing pretty good for the first period. Four shots on that for the Avs, eight for the Flames, so that's good. They already have their amount of shots that they took. One less shot that they took against the Kings, so that's looking positive, I guess. Passing percentage looking crappy for both teams. Penalty minutes, yeah, you got the five-minute majors for the Fighting, and one power play for the Avs, but we do kill it off. Still have not lost a face-off yet, which is good. Calgary's getting the advantages on the face-offs. I guess their centers aren't that good. Duchesne, Linton, McKinnon, I guess. I don't think their face-offs are that good, though. Duchesne's got good face-offs. Yep, there's the first win on the face-off for the Avs. Don't let it lead to a goal, though. Please, Christ. All right, O'Reilly, there's that dish out in front over to Landeskog. He missed them, though. Over to Duchesne. Oh, glove saved by DiPietro on the short side. Do make that save, though. That's Matt Duchesne taking the shot close in like that, too. That worries me sometimes. It's a nice save there, though, by DiPietro. He's going in close. We go butterfly, which is what we needed to do. Go glove. Go butterfly. Make that save on the glove. Those are one of the saves that you make because your glove is not held out like you think it should be in real life. Oh, Jesus. They're running into us again. I'm trying to go out there and face the cross creases, and Alex Tanga goes down. Going for the cross crease. Raymond trying to walk right in, though, but Stewart will take it off him. He goes for a saucer pass, but misses his man on the wing. Brody takes it, though. Nice play to shield it from them. Gives it back to Granlund. Granlund trying to get around Stewart. He does. Back to Brody. Slap shot. Oh, man. Screened by Hudler in front again, but Pekarek. Pekarek does make the glove save. All right. First line back out again. And Marcus Granlund will win it. Brody shot. Oh, tipped out in front. Floated over him, but just over the net, though. Eric Johnson gets it up to Duchesne. Here's Matt Duchesne again. Hits off of him. There's Tyson Barry. Shot blocked, though, by DiPietro. Closes the five hole. And we cover up. All right, Calgary wins the faceoff again. That's good. They're winning the faceoffs this game. I'm all right with covering the puck now since they're doing a good job on the faceoffs tonight. I feel comfortable going for defensive faceoff wins, though. David Jones gets knocked off the puck, gets it back, though. He's really handling it there from Wilson. All right, here's Cleish. Cleish back to Bordolo. Bordolo, ooh, cross crease. Yeah, there was Cleish again. Bordolo. Bordolo with a guy behind me. Siemens blocked out in front, though. A lot of traffic in the way there. And Monahan gets up to David Jones. There's a penalty there. There's an interference call. David Jones takes a shot on Pekarek, and they will go Peter Bordolo. Or is it Patrick? I think it's Peter Bordolo. Will go to the box for an interference call. And Sean Monahan after the play. Yep. I saw that coming up the ice, too. And, oh, it is Patrick. I was right. Patrick Bordolo gets an interference call, and the Flames will go on the power play. So, guys need to take advantage of this. You guys are taking a lot of shots on that. This is top five penalty kill in the league as well, especially with Eric Johnson back there controlling traffic. That's for damn sure. All right, that's going to bounce right in front of me. Weatherspoon has it, though. And they'll give it up to Marcus Granlund, up to Goudreau. Johnny Goudreau dumps it around the back. Nice forecheck there by Hudler. Unfortunately, though, he gets taken right off by Tyson Barry. Up, he poke checks him out in the back, trying to clear. Goudreau out in front to Granlund, but couldn't get it around Pekarek as he will cover up. So Calgary trying out that pass from the point. Trying that point pass. Almost worked there. All right, and another win for Monahan. Wideman takes a shot. Oh, tipped again, but over the net. Second tip shot so far for the Flames. And that goes over the net. Shot by Weatherspoon, but a glove saved by Pekarek, and he'll hold on again. There you go, Calgary. Get shots to those net. That's what I like to see. 13 shots so far in the game. That's nice. Actually, 12. What am I kidding? 12. I haven't scored yet. Johnson gets taken off the puck, though, but they will clear it down as O'Reilly will clear it. Dennis Wideman takes it, and he'll give it up to Barchi, Sven Barchi, over to the wing to Monahan. Stops up, back to Barchi. Barchi takes a shot. Why the net? That was a hard shot. Pekarek up, rebounded. Ooh, right to Barchi almost again. Almost had control of it, but Colorado will dump it down. As Wideman walks down front, gives it up to Raymond. Power play just about over. Power play is over. And Landeskog will intercept. Gives it to Bordolo out of the box. Over to McKinnon. McKinnon, double toe drag. Triple toe drag. Tried to hit Bordolo over to the wing. but the Flames do a good job of breaking that up. Hits Monahan on the wing. Sean Monahan back skates. Tried to hit it back to the point, but nobody there. Raymond will take it. Turns it over to Alex Tanguay, though. He'll dump it into the corner. Colburn outpowers number 29 there. I think that's Nathan McKinney. Outpowers him, and they get the puck back, though. Stewart worked on there. McGinn over to Tanguay. Tanguay with a toe drag. Oh, tried for another cross-crease attempt by Nathan McKinnon, but Joel Colburn intercepts the pass. Nice play there. Doing a good job on defense. Granlund. Oh, rebound. Oh, my God. That play was broke. That play was so broken. Mason Raymond, though, still stays with the play. Him and Marcus Granlund working back and forth with each other. And Mason Raymond will get the goal there, assisted from Mason, from Marcus Granlund and Joel Colburn. Oh, that went off of Brad Stewart's foot. That went off his skate. As Raymond was anticipating the pass, he missed the shot, but then he takes it back as Picard was a little bit too far out of his net. He was anticipating the shot as it was skating over after deflecting off Stewart's stick. Raymond pulls back the puck, though, shoots it on the short side, which he was coming, and the Flames do get that goal there, 1-0 lead for them. Goal from Mason Raymond, assisted from Marcus Granlund and Joel Colburn. So the Flames do take the 1-0 lead here late in the second period. As we're looking good, got that 1-0 lead. Bortolo back to Cleish. Cleish back to Duncan Siemens. Over to Talbot. Talbot back to the point to Wilson. Over to Talbot again. Over to Cleish. Cleish. Or in front to Talbot. There's Bortolo out there in front for a shot. Blocked away though by DiPietro for a second time. Cleish again with a shot. Saved by DiPietro. Saving those short side shots. And here is Max Reinhardt. Max Reinhardt up the wing. Back to Arnold. Back to Reinhardt. Back to Arnold again. Shot blocked in front. Oh, man, that almost squeezed through. I think Wilson makes the save as the puck was almost sliding into the net. Up, oh, there's a low shot there from, I believe, 21, who's at Talbot, I think. Yeah. As they will make the save there, and that'll do it for the second period. So a late kind of rush there for the Avs there in the second period, but a couple nice saves there from DiPietro in the dying third, in the dying minutes of the third period, and almost a very late goal there from the Flames on that play from almost squeaking by Calvin Picard. But the Flames do get on the board there after a broken down play going off of Brad Stewart's skate. Mason Raymond still stayed with it and got the goal as the Flames will go up 1-0 in this game. So 13-11 on the shots. We're killing them in faceoffs, 13-3. Each team with a power play. Passing percentage is fine. Time and attack, fairly close. I do want to take a look, though, at that last play of the period, though. After that puck almost went on Calvin Picard. I want to see what happens. So Max Reinhardt across the blue line gives it back to Bill Arnold. Gives it back to Reinhardt, who skated back a little bit. Back to Arnold, who took a shot. It went off of Wilson's skate. And I think Calvin Picard poke-checked it. Look at that. He poke-checked it on his ass. He poke-checked it with spread fours. And, oh, it's sliding in. Oh, that's a goal. That is a goal. Referee, somebody call Toronto. That's a goal. Oh, my God, Calgary. Calgary Flames got denied a goal because he took possession of it. Oh, my God. Like, did he take possession? When did he technically take possession of it? Probably when the puck starts spinning. Yeah, right there. I guess they'll deny that goal, but that puck is across the net. Oh, man, Calgary. No booth review because the puck, the play was going by too fast. Somebody call Toronto. That's a goal. Calgary gets bullshitted out of a goal there. Unfortunately, it's still a 1-0 game. Should be 2-0. Bill Arnold should have been credited with that goal. Marcus Granlund, though, ties himself up against the boards. Brody gets it and gives it up to Raymond. He'll get taken off, though, by a little bit of an incisive play there from Johnson. Gets away with it, though. Gets it back up to Hudler, though. Hudler will dump it in. Eric Johnson take it to the boards, though. By Raymond out in front. Shot by two double shot there, but saved by Picard. Barry now. Tyson Barry back skating, and he will lose the puck to Granlund. Granlund out in front, though, but taken off by Eric Johnson. Nice defensive play there from him. Here's Landeskog. Landeskog cross crease in front. Up, tried for a diving out play there on Duchesne, but he will turn it over as Hudler will now take it. Yuri Hudler up the middle, over to Raymond on the wing. Back to Granlund, toe drags. Back to Raymond, out front to Hudler. Shot, though, blocked by Colorado defenseman as O'Reilly will get it back up to Duchesne. Over to Eric Johnson. Eric Johnson will go offsides. 13:38 still left here in the third period. Still 1-0 game for the Flames. All right, McKinnon will win this faceoff, though. One of the few faceoff wins for the Avalanche. He'll dump it around. Jones is right there for it. Gets checked, but still stays with it. And he'll get this back up to Stajan. That Stajan deeks over. Oh, nice deke around the defense. Hits it back to Englund. Derek Englund over to Stajan. Stajan around the back of the net. Out in front to back to Englund. Out in front. Oh, couldn't be handled, though, by David Jones as they get back over to Tenge. And begin 2-on-2 here. There's McGinn, wide shot of the net, over the net. Tange tries to go walking out in front, tries to close it off the side of the post, but DiPietro there to cover up. I wonder if that counts. I'm really wondering if that counts as a shot on net. I think so, since I did have to make a save. I guess it does. All right, Siemens. Duncan Siemens tried to make a pass, though, but Sven Barchi takes him off it. Ooh, he gets around one. Sven Barchi stops up, back to Brody, though. Out in front, tries for a dish, but couldn't be handled by Backlund. Talbert tried to get it over there, but Cleish over to Bortolo. Somebody needs to get that guy a pair of glasses because that was well wide. Wilson back over to Siemens. Off to the corner, Talbot, and missed by Siemens all the way back into the Colorado zone. Taken to the boards, though, by Goudreau. Passes back to Talbot and up to Bortolo again. All right, here's Patrick Bortolo. Take it to the boards, though. Taken off by Barchi. 6 minutes left to go here in the third. A little bit of a misplay there, though, but Backlund still has it back. Goudreau, lots of ice there to work with. Johnny Goudreau, Johnny Hockey, make something happen. Back skates, taken off, though, by Nick Holden. And he'll get it up to Jamie McGinn. Up stick lifted. McGinn still has it. 4 minutes left to go here in the third, and he'll get it up to McKinnon. McKinnon toe drags around. Tried to toe drag around three Calgary Flames, but couldn't get that done. Hudler. Turns over to Holden. McGinn back to Tange. Out in front, though. Cross crease. DiPietro, though, sliding across the crease to make the save. Up run into by one of my own players, though. Hudler gets run over by McGinn. McKinnon back to Holden. Back to Stewart. Colorado's threatening here. Back to the point to Stewart again. Back to Holden. Out in front. Up. Save. Squeeze the pads, DiPietro. There you go. Saves that puck with a minute 22 left in the third. Colorado moving the puck very well in our own zone. But DiPietro there to make the save on that shot. Out in front of the crease, which is good. Tange was right there. That could have ended pretty badly, but whatever. 14 saves so far with a minute 22 left. Duchesne back to Eric Johnson, back to O'Reilly. Missed shot there from Landeskog, back to O'Reilly. O'Reilly back to the point to Barry. There's a shot rebound, but Brody right there to hold the rebound. Nice play there from DJ Brody. Gives it up to Monahan with 50 seconds left here to go in this third period. Sean Monahan holding it into the corner. Nice move. Nice power move. Up, hits it over to David Jones. Up, Monahan takes it back. Shot on that, but saved by Picard. Stajan gets it back. Stajan taken off the puck, though, by Ryan O'Reilly. Gets it up to Barry, and he'll give it over to Duchesne. He will dump it in. Empty net for the Avs. Picard to the bench. Dennis Weidman up. Taken off the puck by Landeskog. Out in front to O'Reilly. Puck is sitting right there, but DiPietro clears the crease. Monahan. Weidman gets it up to Monahan. Over to David Jones. Shot on the net. Hits the empty netter, David Jones. And that'll pretty much secure the win for the Calgary Flames. There's still 18 seconds to go. Can Rick DiPietro get his third shutout of the year? Nice play, though, by Dennis Weidman. Nice save at the other end by DiPietro to keep that in the net. If Sean Monahan would have taken a shot on it, that might have been an assist for me. But nice unselfish play there by Sean Monahan. Dished it over to David Jones, who wasn't even being covered. Long shot past the blue line into the empty netter. And 2-0 for the Flames. But there's still 18 seconds still left here. Can DiPietro hold on for the shutout? Colorado's probably going to pull their goalie again. Granlund wins the faceoff over to Englund, up to Hudler. Hudler gets taken off, though, by Eric Johnson. And they're going to pull their goalie again. Eric Johnson around the back of the net. DiPietro, oh, it's in front. There was nobody in front. DiPietro tried to cut it off, though. Mason Raymond, he'll miss the empty net, though. But there we go. DiPietro almost cost himself his third NHL shutout. Oh, we get an achievement. There we go. I'll take that. Good start. That's perfectly fine with me. DiPietro almost gave up the shutout there He was going around the back of the net. Luckily, Ryan O'Reilly missed it out in front, and luckily the Calgary Flames defense was there to cover the slot. But Calgary does manage to walk away with a 2-0 win. Calvin Picard actually did have a pretty good night in net for his first start of the year. Saved 16 of 18. But Rick DiPietro was on the other end of that ice, and he shows up with a 16-save shutout of the Colorado Avalanche for his 5th win of the year and his 3rd shutout of the year. So Rick DiPietro, more than half of his wins this year have been shutouts. That's ridiculous. 5 wins, 5 losses, 3 shutouts. Save percentage probably got better because of this. Goals against average will hopefully get lowered from that. This game definitely is a very good one to recover after that LA Kings loss, and a very good game from the Flames. They contended with one of the better teams stat-wise for the top of the league. Their record didn't show up, but they had a very good penalty kill and power play. And you know what? They killed off a power play from, I think, a couple power plays from Colorado. No, they only killed off one power play for each team, and they killed it off, which is good. They definitely dominated in the center, in the face-off circle, that's for sure. One double the amount of face-off. So good on Calgary to get that win. 3 stars of the game. Mason Raymond with the one, pretty much the game-winning goal that he got in the off of that broken down play. And the 2 goaltenders get the first and the second stars of this game. Calvin Picard with a 1.0 goals against average for him, with a save percentage of 94%, 16 saves for him on his first start of the year. Very good start for Calvin Picard. But Rick DiPietro was a little bit better. Save percentage of 100, 16 saves for his 3rd shutout of the year and his 5th win to go back to 500 at 5-5. So very good game yet again. What can I say, guys? This game mode is now fun. This series is now fun because you're just getting better at goaltending now. And if anybody wants to argue, oh, you probably lowered the difficulty. It's still on Superstar, guys. I don't have the time to set up these amazing circumstances and stuff like that. I just play this Be a Pro whenever I have time to. And see, it actually has taken off our save percentage at 0.9%. And I guess because our save percentage is up to a 0.9, so they've taken that off of our season expectations. Now they just want us to suit up for 23 games on the year. So they've taken that off of us, which is good. We already had that check, so that's probably why they're not showing it. Goals against average of 2.48. We have a goals against average of 1.67. Our save percentage is at 90%. We already got 3 shutouts. So we figured you can deliver 3 shutouts this season. We already got that, which is great. 13 wins this year. We're almost halfway to that, which is good. And they want us to suit up for 23 games this year. So hopefully we can do that. We've already suited up for 11, I guess. We've already suited up for 11. I guess we might have got into a game that Hiller might have struggled a bit. But still, we got the win there, got a lot more experience, and we got our team a win, which they desperately needed, which is good. And once again, we can hopefully take a little bit of a break here, let Hiller start some games. And there's that injury to Chris Russell, as we saw. So another injury to our defense. Only getting worse and worse with this defense for the Calgary Flames. Hopefully by the time we get a start again, Smead's back, okay, so that means at least we get one back, but another person is there. Giordano's back, okay, so good. The defense are coming back, which is good. And we get to suit up for our 2nd game in a row. Back-to-back starts. Interesting. So, very, very interesting. This is the first time all year that we've had back-to-back starts now. Going up against the Pittsburgh Penguins, we have not played this team since our very first start coming back into the league last year with the New York Islanders. We have not played the Penguins since then. So get a little bit of a nice little rematch here with Sidney Crosby and them. So I guess the organization saw us with that 2-0 win again, and they're rewarding us with another start here. So Hiller, I guess he's making his money. Hiller's probably loving this right now. He gets to sit on the bench probably making like $5 million a year, while we're earning that minor league contract money still. But hey, we gotta do work. You gotta play those games. You gotta win these games in order to get that money. But we're going up against the Pittsburgh Penguins up next. All right, so let's check out what our lines are gonna be next time. Do with the injuries. Hopefully, some people got back. So we still have, okay, first line's still the same. Second line still the same. Third line still the same. And Arnold's back. Okay, so Colburn's back on the fourth line. That's good. So Reinhardt gets called back down. Unfortunately, or probably sitting on the bench, whatever, healthy scratch. And the defense is back to normal with the exception of Chris Russell, as Englund is still going to be playing back there. So probably when Chris Russell gets back, Englund will probably take a seat. And like we said, we're on Hiller's still right there. Yep, Hiller. Hiller's right there. He's having his grand old time. No, he's having a good old time this year. What are his stats like so far this year? Let me see what Hiller's doing so far this year. He's played 36 games so far this year. He's going 16-16 with a 2.67 goals against average, save percentage of .914 with 3 shutouts. So he's had a lot of starts. He's a .500 goalie. And then we take a look at Rick DiPietro's stats, who is 5-5 with a 1.66 goals against average, probably 1.67. They'll probably round that up. And a save percentage of .89 something. They probably round that up to .9 and 3 shutouts on the year. So obviously it's much better than last year. Ignore those 3 wins. That was a little bit of an issue that we had with the simulating last year, but whatever. So Schittsburg coming up next. Cindy Crosby, Evgeny Malkin coming up next for us. So get to revisit one of the teams that we struggled with our very first game of the year. We only left 3 goals in that first game against Pittsburgh, which was pretty good, but it's time to get some revenge. Let's show Pittsburgh how good of a goaltender we have come in a year's time. So Calgary versus Pittsburgh next, still on this long road trip. We're still on the road going up in Pittsburgh coming up next. So that'll be next on the list, guys. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed, leave a like, leave a comment, subscribe as always. I'll see you guys next time.